I was first elected in 2005. It wasn't something that I always wanted to be, so I didn't start off wanting to be a Member of Parliament. I actually wanted to be a children's presenter at one stage. I studied computers at college, and my first job was a computer programmer. But I became very active in the trade union movement. There was a seat once, it was in Hackney, and the guys couldn't stand for that seat because it was all women shortlist. So they started calling me because they wanted a trade unionist, saying, would I stand? And I was like, no, I'm fine. People don't like MPs, politicians, you know. I was quite happy being liked as a full-time trade union rep. But then afterwards I thought, well, I could be the kind of MP that I want to be, and even though I didn't see people like me in Parliament, they didn't look like me or they didn't speak like me, I thought I could give it a go. And so that was kind of my motivation, and knowing that I could be a different MP and make a difference to other people like me.
I became a member of the House of Lords in 2001. It was a process of applying. It was the first time that the so-called people's peers were set up. My motivation was very much that of making a contribution.
What motivated me to become a Member of Parliament? Well, it's a difficult question. I mean, I was always very interested in politics when I was school, maybe sort of 15, 16. But I actually went to read history at university, and then I did a number of jobs in financial services. But always at the back of my mind, I was very interested in people, how people interacted, about issues, about the government. These sorts of experiences really meant that I was much more focused about trying to become a Member of Parliament, trying to represent people, a community.
I was motivated to become a Member of Parliament because I was a young lawyer. I would be going into prisons and meeting young people who had been arrested. I would be representing people who had lost money through a small business. And I kept coming back to, why is it like this? Why are these kids in prison? Why is this company going bust? And I think I was the kind of lawyer that was interested in policy. How do you change the world so these young people aren't in prison? How do you fix the world so this business doesn't go bust? It wasn't just dealing with one problem, one thing at a time. It was changing the whole world, changing the whole context. The world can be a better place.